he has their attention, it would break the spell. Because he has their attention.
Guys, be good. Friendly people here.
They have more than 4 hit dice.
So they remain aware of everybody around them.
And they're indifferent. To you.
But he has their attention. So they're paying attention to him and indifferent to him.
The effect lasts as long as you speak or sing to a maximum of 1 hour. Those enthralled by your words take no action while you speak or sing until 1d3 rounds thereafter while they discuss the topic or performance.
Bye, Harambe!
Did you see that?
So what if we went back up that rope?
Well, yeah, the rope's still there. Yeah,
you can let him distract. Distract it. Oh my god.
Depending on how high you roll. Alright, so, guys, are we just going to leave him behind and run?
So, I think
if we don't go up the rope, then he can just, on his turn, go up before they get another turn.
Yeah, they do get a well.
And then you have a ready action to pull it up if they try to come up.
And everyone will take a ready action to pull it up when they come up. There's some fat people on the rope.
Basically, you can continue performing to the rope. What if I perform climbing up the rope?
You're singing.
Yeah, think about this.
No, he's talking.
I have such a high climb ability.
Yeah, you're a high climber.
I believe that they would be. That I could use that as a performance.
You'd have to give me a perform check to show me that you could perform while climbing.
Yes,
I know.
Well,
you can still do it
on train. I don't have
perform. And it doesn't require perform check.
No.
Did it say it? I don't think it said that it requires the perform check.
You must speak or sing without interruption for one full round. And then as long as you continue speaking or singing.
Okay. So.
So you can speak while climbing. Yeah.
I will tell them about Eugene.
God, let me tell you about you.
So, what's your idea? Some all to sleep. Good idea.
No, they will be raving about Eugene for 1d3
Eugene for thousands of worshippers.
That he doesn't really need.
Right, so all this hinges on them getting a well save. What's your DC?
My DC, that would be 10 plus my caster level.
No. Level doesn't enter
the spell level.
Yes.
10 plus spell level plus my charisma.
Uh-huh.
So
no,
be...
plus your wisdom.
Wisdom,
your
yes. Wisdom.
Even better.
So it would be 17.
Eugene!
Really? You're going to look over my special DM screen?
I was looking for red flashes over there.
No flashes.
They failed.
Yay! Alright, cast rope trick.
How many rope tricks did you have, Malraz?
No, the rope's still there.
He just told you to cast rope trick.
Yeah.
I didn't know it was not
there. How long does it stay there? until somebody jerks it up.
Until it stays there for 12 hours unless we pull it up.
It stays there until somebody jerks it up.
It stays there for 12 hours until somebody
jerks it.
Not me.
All right. Oh, great. I'm like on the other side of the planet.
Okay. All right. So he is talking all about how Eugene and how Eugene wants everybody that's not a Hellwalk to go up the road.
So they move us up the road.
No, it's in the player's handbook.
Wait now.
Okay, we are now up.
I got you, babe. We're back up the road.
And I imagine I can continue.
Is there a cleric? Oh, wait, hold on. We forgot the other cleric.
Oh, yeah. Harambe. Whenever you come up, grab the unconscious cleric.
Nah, the druid bricked him up.
Put my dark companion in there, too.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
All right. So you all make it up there. And let's see how many more rounds they spend. All right,
pull up the rope. Pull up the rope.
How wonderful the performance was. Okay. Alright. You pull the rope up.
With our band
cut off.
And we're all up.
Uh-huh.
Wait, but how are we gonna know when
we're gone? Yeah, we're not gone.
Here's what we're gonna do.
They should have told them that they should go to the planet. They should go to the temple of Eugene.
We just need to recover.
Yeah. Why don't we sit here?
Now we have a...
We can't.
We can't recover because he's here.
We can't recover, A, because he's there, and B, because the road trip only lasted 12 hours and was only early morning.
So I mean, I can recover.
You could have told them that they need to go worship Eugene in a, you know, in a temple somewhere.
No, that's not how that works.
Yeah, blame it on him.
That's not how the spell works. Basically, they just sit there and listen for a while.
They're indifferent, but they listen. They're like, I'm listening. They're intrigued by you, but they
are
don't
listen. Are we sure he won't
you.
Fit in the Huey Sandy Haversack?
Yeah.
I don't know what's the storage space.
It's a 10 by 10 foot, right?
Yeah.
You stuffed him in the bag.
Okay, I would stuff you in the bag and then put you in the corner.
Fine, I've been buried. What the hell is stuffing me in the bag?
Can I go jail? Wait, I have to breathe.
No.
Hey, I'm sticking the stinky guy in the bag.
What about the idea of sticking deodorant?
And then once we do that, I can actually start healing.
My hand.
I have something for him.
Hey, Rambe, you have less respiration, right?
You know, you could be start meditating right now.
Yeah, I'm meditating.
No, I'm just talking about something else for me.
Look, if you meditate for 12 hours, then you only have 12 more hours to go.
Uninterrupted.
It will be uninterrupted.
You tell Lewis is having such a great time.
I think you should.
Lewis is
unconscious. Quick.
So I'm stuffing this guy in your Tandy Haversack, okay? This guy is now.
He won't fit in it.
It's 10 by, I thought it was 10 feet.
Harambe, fortunately, since you have lesser restoration,
what
can get our other cleric back up, too.
What book?
How much of them you managed to get in there?
What book is it, then?
The Master's Guide. Wondrous item. You were Sandy Haversack.
Can it be, like, up to my neck and at least reduce some of the smell?
And
you turn my neck with the bag.
You spend hours, half a day around him. All right, so...
No.
Okay.
Sorry for my BO.
The side pouches are obviously not going to be. You're talking about the main central portion, up to 8 cubic feet.
There we go. He is totally
a square,
up 8 cubic feet.
2 feet by 2 feet by 2 feet.
If you scrunch up the little ball,
I can go
get some of them in there.
All but my feet. On my head. You have to choose which one.
How tall are you?
6'3".
It had to be problematic, didn't you?
Yeah.
Couldn't just be 5'11", then we could have fit you in.
Wait, hold on. Actually, I might have something for that.
He's not an animal.
If you have two bags, you put half of me in one and half of the other.
They cut you into three pieces. They could put half of a third of you in each pocket.
Can I regenerate?
Cast it.
Him. Lesser restoration.
Poof.
All right. So all of a sudden, the cleric gets
four decks more.
Four decks. You are now non-paralyzed.
What was that?
Him coming back to move.
Quick, do the scream.
I don't have it today.
Anybody need healing?
I do.
Actually, I'm going to do a first aid.
Should have picked up that.
Excellent.
Should have picked up that body on the way down.
No.
Oh, it's not going
to
eat it.
Yeah, you couldn't put all the way into the sack. Could we, by any chance, do a slight size modification?
Here's the other problem that you're going to run into. You're in a pocket dimension. You don't have access to the pocket dimension of the healing. So you have to have it only connects to the prime material point. So you can't access.
So it's just it's
you can't open a pocket dimension inside a pocket dimension.
Why?
Would you like to know what happens if you open a
black hole
inside a portable hole?
Black hole.
That would be interesting.
All right. So let's see. Bag of folding.
I mean. What's the worst that could happen?
Black hole!
Shut up.
I may not be able to procreate anymore.
Okay, so.
We're dead.
If a bag of holding is placed within a portable hole, a rift to the astral plane is torn in that place. Both the bag and the cloth are sucked into the void and forever lost. If a portable hole is placed within a bag of holding, it opens a gate to the astral plane. The hole of the bag and any creatures within a 10-foot radius are drawn there. The portable hole in the bag of holding being destroyed in the process. So,
Black hole.
You can create a portal from the happening.
You were thinking Haversack has a fail safe. And it will not allow itself to be opened while inside this pocket dimension.
Open up, you stupid bag.
Fortunately, this is neither a portable hole nor bag of holding.
They both open pocket dimension.
You have to do something different based on which order you do it.
Okay, so which would you think is going to happen? I could roll randomly to see whether everybody's thrown into the astral plane.
I mean, I'd be fine.
Yichin could get us back.
You know, like we got to a high, if I got to a high enough level, I could use greater teleport.
Wait, yeah.
And then we could go visit Yichin and say, how can we destroy these wasps? He hands us a magic weapon.
Okay,
we go
so
back down.
Are you going to do anything about the rest of your remaining decks, or are you hoping to sleep it off over the next few weeks?
Let me sleep. I don't have a spell.
You don't have lesser restoration? That's
not,
the most powerful spell.
Memorized, or not available to me today, because I can't pray long enough to get it, because it smells bad.
It does. Smell incredibly bad in here. It is amazingly, totally bad. You can't believe that the party decided to ruin this extra-dimensional space by bringing such rancid garbage.
After an hour or so, can we take a peek?
That's up to you.
Seeing the wasps are still there.
You open it, and if the wasps are lurking, they're flying right up inside, because they're certainly ready in action to travel up inside there. Because
they saw us go up and
they have intelligence. They're intelligent. They certainly do that. As a matter of fact,
I mean,
the last
manager
said they act tactically.
You see, that'll wait here 8 hours?
If I were higher, I'd have Ice Storm.
Mm-hmm.
That
would be useful.
That
would be useful.
Well, if we stay up here?
I'm only minus one.
Mallet, if we stay up here 8 hours, can you learn that?
No, I need to level up.
Yeah,
game 50.
Okay.
So, Wizard.
So,
you have to find
some
way
to
do this.
You too. It's up to you.
I need this guy to get out of here so that we can rest.
Forest fires.
But
so,
if we open up that hole and the wasps are still there, they're going to come on up.
Do you think I could purify him as food and drink?
Huh.
Very good question.
Could he purify him as food and drink? He's already a corpse.
And you did say you could use it on corpses.
I am a living corpse.
Aren't we all?
Yeah. Aren't we just a bunch of rotting bones? I mean,
we're discussing business here.
Every
how
day.
How would you smell nicer?
I don't have an
air
freshener.
I can
got
show
any roses?
You
we can freshen up your meat.
Anyone have any roses?
Tell me, would you
wait,
like your
hold
meat
on.
To be fresh?
Absolutely.
Can I neutralize poison on him?
No.
That only heal him.
Wait, but it is poison.
That would heal him.
No, it does not affect people that are immune to poison.
I use my wand 5 times.
Look, I'm holding back gastroreflux and all this other stuff that can make it even smellier.
I can make you a fresh corpse.
All right.
Make him a fresh corpse.
All the ladies will come to you after that. Even some living ones.
If we had some kind of bubble, if you had some kind of spell that made a bubble.
That ship has sailed.
What?
Can we cover him with a bunch of blankets?
Maybe if he has bit all of you, then you could all sleep.
What does a forked shield do?
What is a what?
Is it a forked shield?
What forked shield?
Entropic.
Entropic shield.
Entropic shield, it covers you with a force field that deflects incoming missiles.
100%
mischance.
Will it also prevent smell from leaving?
No.
What? It's a force field.
Does that actually have a nice smell?
Okay, I'm going to read the description of the spell to you, and you tell me if it says anything about deodorizing.
Okay, it's a force field.
This is what it says it does. It would be funny if it says this spell does absolutely nothing to neutralize the smell of rancid.
See, that's where it comes to your discretion, deal.
I already described.
Wait, you said that the water got rid of it for a short time, right?
No, I said he bathed, and it did not make any better. The magical field appears around you, glowing with a chaotic blast of multicolored hues. His field deflects incoming arrows, rays, and other ranged attacks. Each ranged attack directed at you for which the attacker must make an attack roll has a 20% mischance, similar to the effects of concealment. Other attacks that simply work at a distance, such as a dragon's breath weapon, are not effective.
It's only incoming missiles. It's not outgoing missiles.
Okay, it's not a force field that surrounds my body.
Technically, isn't his smell a poison?
Guys, I'm asking a question.
Is it an acid or a poison smell?
Is Tropic Shield a force field that surrounds my body?
No music whatsoever!
Hold on. You have Mage Armor, right?
Yeah.
Cast that on him! That one actually is a force field that will completely surround him.
Wait.
That must trap the smell.
Will Mage Armor trap the smell?
I mean, it should be a roll for it or something.
Heavy.
You need a roll for it.
I don't know. That's just at your discretion.
You have...
It's a force field, right? I asked the question, is it a force field or not? Does it surround my body with a shield of protection?
Damn.
Is specific. It says exactly what it does. It has no effect.
I don't think that they would thought that a wizard would be a person like me that stinks at the high heaven and that they would need a shield to protect his plane. I don't think it's even fathom.
It is a part of who you are, and so far none of the suggestions have had anything to do with the reek that is emanating from the body. Now, I'm not saying that there could not be something. But the things that have been mentioned will not stop the foulness that is existing.
I have knowledge arcana, so I can roll for that because I can know what will protect me. Protect
you can roll for it. Also, I will try to think about anything that is within your power.
Well, anything within anybody's power. I'm rolling for knowledge.
Know what they can do.
I'm not asking for knowledge of what will prevent my stink from leaving my body to other members.
All right.
Can we take the 40 on this?
We're
going to
be here for a while.
Natural,
he just got 20.
Natural 20. Okay, so I didn't have to do anything.
See.
And that time I prayed to Jesus, I said, Jesus. Like that.
So
sorry,
I just want to say, I like to think of myself as a very intelligent and humble person.
Okay.
Right, I'd like to assist
him. I'm going to go ahead and tell you that if you immersed yourself in holy water,
I would die.
Eventually, the stink would dissipate.
That's a thought.
That's the first part.
That's the only one.
Okay, what else do we have?
I'm serious. The purified food and drink.
Okay, well, let's look at purified food and drink and see if it neutralizes the stench coming off of it.
It purifies.
Right, hold on. What about
neither food nor drink?
What about protection from evil?
Well, somebody's food.
I mean, I can't be in it, but that's okay.
Yeah, I love how, out of all the people that are going to look at you, it's
just... specifically, if bodies... Hold on. I could purify bodies.
Is his smell technically considered a poison? Because it is harming us.
And if you're immune to poison, you're immune to
it. It is.
Go right on.
Because they're so awesome.
It's negative.
Okay, I'm doing one thing at a time. The style makes spoiled, rotten, poisonous, or otherwise contaminated food and water. He is not food or water.
I weren't food.
What if I plan on eating him?
No, he is a creature.
Put an apple in my mouth.
Does not prevent
put me on a silver plate and stick an apple in my mouth.
The spell has no effect on creatures of any type. Does that answer your question?
I asked about corpses.
Right. Once the creature is dead, it's no longer a creature.
He's dead.
He was dead.
He's still
he
dead.
Got better. Okay? No.
There are wounds on him. See if he fixes him.
You have a question.
Yes. Is he, because the smell is technically harming us, could it be considered a poison?
It is considered a poison only for figuring out whether people that are immune to poison are affected by it. Let me look this up to give you the exact.
Because response. I was going to say, if so, could I cast delay poison on myself and then deal the rest?
Hold on, let's see. All right, there we go. Okay, yes, no.
Would protection from evil do it?
It would probably give you a +2 to save against it, but you're not getting getting a save because you are... Hold on a second. Okay. But, creatures with immunity to poison are unaffected, and creatures resistant to poison receive their normal bonus on their saving throw. Let's see.
So, if I become immune to it, it shouldn't affect me.
If you become immune to it, then it will not affect you.
All right, then. I would like to cast Delay Poison on myself.
Okay, and how long does that work?
It lasts for 1 hour per level, and I'm 6 levels, so 6 hours.
So, okay, so you guys entered into this area in mid-morning. It is not yet noon, so call it maybe 10 o'clock. So 4 o'clock in the afternoon, your Delay Poison will wear off.
All right.
You can rest starting at about 11 o'clock at night.
All right, so I only have to last 7 more hours. Well,
okay.
I got time for
so
me.
He's taking care of himself.
I can't help him.
Anybody else doing anything that matters?
I can.
Okay. All right, so I. By the way, I am not going to look through every single spell in the book.
I'm dummy.
I think that Lewis would be willing to leave at that point. Wait and see. Basically...
I'm thumbing through it.
Anything that would render one immune to poison would take care of the problem. As far as making you not stink...
What about our magic tree token?
No.
Maybe it tastes like Alpine Air Freshener.
Can I ask about
magic tree token?
Does Bloodwind smell better than him?
Does Bloodwind say it smells bad?
Does it make a nice gust?
Yeah, does it make a nice gust of blood in the air?
Alright, so we're just going to say that unless you guys can come up with something very quickly, that as long as he is in this space with you, you are not going to be able to get relaxing rest.
Man, let's take a
please go
rest.
Out!
You can
please.
Do so.
We can wait till he says there's 7
terrible.
Hours and I'll take a peek for the team.
Actually, if somebody, say, had water breathing and I... had a 2-gallon container full of water, couldn't they breathe from that and relax? Get restful sleep? Because the water does not smell bad.
It's a point.
Okay, how long do you think water breathing lasts?
I can check.
No idea.
Hold on.
I don't have it, personally.
So it doesn't really matter, does it?
But Kane has it.
I have water, though.
I learned that just because I wanted to be able to use it at some point tonight. Looks like I'll be able to do that.
So okay. In the morning, you guys are going to show me what spells you have memorized.
Got it.
Because this is bullshit. All right? You guys are pulling spells out of your ass that you never would have had memorized.
No, actually, I
would
have wanted that one.
You would not.
Yes.
You're nowhere near a body of water.
I know, but
actually,
I
he was talking to me about that one earlier.
Wait and see if maybe he could catch water
breathing.
You saw
how Kane was earlier about if he gave me a greater than you think.
He was experimenting with trying to make fish drown in water.
So
I'm serious with that one. He really was. He really was trying to make fish drown in water.
That's fine. That's what druids do. They like murdering innocent animals.
No, I'm not scared.
Not
okay,
a very good
so
druid.
The hexblade can rest. And relax.
Me too.
At night. Right. And the tiefling can rest and relax.
Oh, we got Chatty Bell. Two of our bodies
is
100 degrees. Yeah, 200 degrees to keep us warm.
And then you split it among the number of people you're wanting to affect.
Yep. There's only a couple
two people.
People.
That's 6 hours.
That's
only a couple people that actually need that. Who all needs it?
Well, I don't have anything to make water.
I have water.
Okay.
2 gallons, so you can comfortably fit your head in it.
I'm being honest with the water. I am.
Yeah, I did have it.
Okay, so how many people are going to be immersing their faces in this water?
Or could
not
I
me.
Cast it multiple times?
How long does
it?
It? How long does it?
Like a wizard who can memorize their spells at any time.
How long does it last?
He has to have 8 hours of rest,
yes,
before he memorizes stuff.
So,
what
Kane,
if he's immersed the hexblade in the water?
The other problem you're going to run into
hey, wait,
is
right
that he'll be emerging from the,
it's water. No, as long as not
the rope trick at 10 p.m.
So how long have we been in there?
Not very long, I imagine. Here's a very good question.
What?
Do the wasps know how long it'll last?
You don't know.
We know they
won't.
How long are they willing to wait?
Okay, well, then, so no one has any better ideas?
So far, he's hoping to get some delay poison for 6 hours.
Oh, that's another thing here.
If he gets rest, can he learn another spell?
None of you can get rest, because you can't memorize spells again until tomorrow morning.
Oh, he can't.
So, I guess we'll just wait until time runs out, and then if he's still there, I'll leave.
Okay. Alright, so that's your plan. What's your plan?
Hold on.
Hold on.
You can pee.
Puking.
Are you sure you don't want me to test the water breathing?
I am puking. I am miserable. I'm almost willing to sacrifice myself to fucking bugs.
Okay. Alright.
I have.
What are you doing?
Mitchell, get more spells if he were to rest for 8 hours.
You can only get spells back every 24 hours.
Okay.
Dang it.
So,
not even for water breathing.
Resting at night.
Well,
and I'm
going to
assume that Mitchell only has one of these rope tricks memorized. Because you guys weren't expecting to use it.
Are you sure we weren't expecting to put a hex blade in one and other people in the other?
Even if he did, he probably would have only done a first level rope trick for the hex blade, since it would just have to be up there 6 hours. Okay, so anything that you guys are doing before this rope trick dissipates and you all flop down to the ground.
Boy, this is the best indie game ever. I think they actually get worse each time.
You're saying my D&D game is bad?
Yes.
For what?
Hold on, let me see what time it is.
It's 9:40.
And we're still on our first thing.
9:43, and we're still on our first random encounter.
Okay, what do you want me to do about it? It's a CR8. You guys are more than able to handle this.
Wrong.
We don't have the ability.
However, in practicality, nobody was prepared for this.
All right. Well, now you've learned.
Yes, our wizard has learned.
Yeah, Cone of Cold is
Wizard
5.
All right, so
do we have
flopping.
A fifth level wizard?
Are you doing anything?
I'm really getting tired of being mage. Does
right.
anything to not flop?
Are you flopping?
Do we have a fifth level wizard that can do Cone of Cold?
You could.
No, we do not have an 11th level wizard.
Fifth.
11.
I'm looking.
It's a fifth level spell. It means you have to be 11th level wizard.
Oh.
Or ninth. One of the two.
Ninth.
Ninth level. Are you flopping? David, are you flopping?
Yes, I already said I was flopping. I was the first one to say I'd flop.
Okay, are you flopping?
I think I should look first.
Okay, you can look.
You don't know what time it would be.
You have no idea unless you sit there and go 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, 4 Mississippi, up to 10 Mississippi.
And then I can flop.
You could roll a D20 possibly, right?
Oh,
and
let's see. I would say give me a wisdom check, D20, and see to be able to figure out when...
Well,
17. Okay, I think it's been 12 hours. You think it's been 11 hours and 59 minutes. You have 1 minute left before the spell expires.
So I take 20 seconds to take a pee.
Okay.
I jump out.
Okay,
Cowabunga!
So reopen the hole and you cowabunga out.
Let's
I'm
do this.
I'm going to look out after just to see if he's...
And everybody else plopping out? I mean, I only got a minute left, otherwise I'm staying there.
You,
I stick there forever, right? I stick there.
They were going to plop out after the spell gave away.
That's well.
So you were going to decide that
it is. Oh, I thought I was doing what they were doing.
Put the room back up! Put the room back up! Put the room back up!
Don't rock on the chair.
Great. Yeah, we all have.
Put the room back up! Put the room back up! Put the room back up!
You said I had a minute left before the spell ends anyway.
That's what I think.
I rolled a 17. That's what
you
I think.
You don't know what you rolled. It's not a
Put the rope back up. Put the rope back up. Put the rope back up. Put the rope back up.
I take a peek out.
That's it. I think it's time. And he opens the hole and he cowabungas out.
Can we close the hole?
And
we pull the rope
back.
Okay. I said real quick that I want to see if there's anything attacked.
Right. There's people that want to look
out. All right, here we go.
I did say I'm looking out to see if he gets attacked.
Yes, and as you go to look out, he closes the hole. He pulls the rope back.
So, do I lose some hairs from the whole
No, but you can reopen
all
it if you want.
All of them? Does that include my armpits?
Yep.
And your pubes.
Oh, no.
And all your leg hair. And any.
I know, no, because I can't be looking like I shaved. God damn it, no.
Any knuckle hair, too.
I'm not Zach.
You do not have knuckle hair, nor do you have foot knuckle hair.
Foot. Sorry, but Jack, you went too far. You're saying I'm acting like Zach and shaving. My head.
I never said anything about Zach.
Yes, but you're saying I'm like Zach and I'm shaved.
No.
Alright,
I said that he lost all of your hairs.
He lost all the hairs.
All of them.
I gotta use the
bathroom. Okay, so a minute later, the spell dissipates, and you guys plop to the ground.
Wow, he's really good at focusing. He was able to tell.
and he's nowhere to be seen.
Okay, bye.
The bugs are nowhere to be seen. The dead body that they were inhabiting is nowhere to be seen.
Do we smell him anywhere?
There's a lingering odor, but considering that you just spent the past 12 hours...
Hold on. He has sense.
Right?
And he can probably track him, too.
I do have track.
Puppy nose.
You know what? Why do we want to track the guy who smells like shit?
He's not exactly wrong.
Okay.
Why do we want to track the guy who smells worse than shit?
You can smell the direction that he's gone in.
So
seems to head off into the woods.
So do we want to follow the guy? Hey, Aster. Do we want to follow the guy that makes it impossible for us to rest?
Yes.
Okay.
Because he is a member of our party. And he is loose.
Okay, hold on. You say that, but y'all let my wolf die. My brother.
Yeah, the gargoyles killed it.
Y'all didn't try and help him?
We did. Well, I didn't because I was paralyzed. But, you know, other people did.
I was
also
paralyzed.
So.
Me too. I was paralyzed.
Paralyzed.
I believe I was dying.
And me too.
I
was dying and paralyzed.
He's stabilized.
Yes.
Okay. Well, the Harambe has pointed off into the woods.
Back to the direction. I can
smell him, can't you?
I don't automatically get sent from being raised by wolves.
Yeah, you do not.
I know.
You can train yourself to do it, though.
No, you do not get to learn to have scent. It's a function of your genetics.
Yeah, there's things that you have to do here.
You can train yourself to hear better.
Oh, those.
I'll
be back.
Pay better attention to things, but you're still limited as to the number of neurons your brain has set aside for it.
That's not my turn right now, is it?
Give me a spot check.
If it's your entire life.
I don't know.
Will, I believe, could influence you.
Will is. Spot check. Oh, is 15.
Okay. You see them on the road and you see Harambe point towards you.
That's cool. Hi, guys. What took you so long?
It's only been a minute.
Really?
Yeah. Like a lifetime of love, you guys! Great, so let's go.
Yay! Alright, so.
Book 3, Sojourn, available May 1991.
Yeah. You. No! Bang!
So, again, where does blue corn come from?
Blue corn.
It's normal corn.
It's blue corn.
Why is it blue?
Because it's the normal color of corn.
It's literally just blue growing corn.
It's like a dollar. All right, it's now 10 o'clock at night. It is dark.
It is
very
also
dark.
Is it a full moon?
Yeah, and it was a $5
bag. $5
These are organic chips.
So $2.
Sure.
All right,
and
so
half.
With low life, it's
okay.
With the full moon, you can certainly see well enough.
$2 for the rest of that bag,
and I'll be fine.
Hold on.
Thank you.
You're going to give that money to your mother, right, who bought you those chips for you?
Well, now that you bring that up, no. I can't.
You blame him.
You're going to have to do some bribing of this guy. You already bribed this guy. He was down for it. But this guy was not cool with it.
His mother bought him those chips specifically because she No. Firstborn.
Yes, Sauron the Escaped.
Sure about that?
Yeah.
Sure, that's why.
That's what she told me.
That's what she said.
I thought for sure that she got some for herself. And I said, oh, those look really tasty. She said, yeah, I bet they do. Can I have some? Yes.
So, now what? It's 10 o'clock at night. It is a full moon, so you, those of you with low light vision technically can see. But
so I can see a full range color at this point, because I have dark vision.
Dark vision is what you want.
In complete darkness.
Okay.
So I have perfect
vision. Do you have low light vision also?
My vision
yes,
is not
actually applies as low light vision. Also,
you can have dark vision and low light vision.
It's dark vision and low light.
I see in color in darkness.
I see color in detail. Right now, in low light.
Lewis is really regretting his being here.
Yeah. So, everyone else go to sleep.
Well, maybe you could step up and be party leader, because so far the party leader is more interested in playing video games. And
excuse you.
And talking about Harambe memes.
Excuse you! I didn't do that yet. I also did not do that.
Fine.
My character was paralyzed for a while, so I can't really say anything.
Can we sleep? Sleep?
I was paralyzed quite a while, actually.
You can camp and sleep. I'm going to roll for random encounters.
Do we have another rope trick?
No, he does not.
I have alarm. I can set up an alarm for when that will go off. When
okay, then we're, I guess we'll camp on the road.
We're camping on the road.
I am casting alarm.
The Hexblade's going to be taking every watch.
Like far away, really far away.
No, he's not that far. If Harambe makes it to him,
he only needs to be 10 feet away.
Do I have to rest?
Yeah, more like
Hexblade, you need to come closer to us so you can watch us while we camp.
Do I have to rest?
Alright, he's keeping watch.
You have to rest?
I'm resting.
You will be fatigued tomorrow if you're not.
I'm special.
Yeah.
You are special. So you'll be specially fatigued tomorrow.
But, you know, outsiders don't have heat sleep or anything left.
And if you were just an outsider, that'd be special. But...
You're not just an outsider.
I'm an outsider. Long day an outsider. Not an inside ape,
if you were a celestial ape, you'd still not be an outsider. That reminds me. I have something very important to do tonight. An in-character discussion to have with Lewis.
Oh.
Outside. No.
Oh.
Interesting.
Yep.
Yep. Oh, since we're on the ground, I do have tents that I can prepare.
You have what?
I have tents.
Tents. Okay.
With, like, bedrolls.
The monsters will never... I'm totally fooled by that.
I'm going to bury myself a small...
Well, I have a lawn. I have a lawn that lets me... That lets us
DM,
know
be here too.
There are monsters nearby. Okay.
I need to be there.
Yeah.
Our DM has to be involved in all
discussions. What happened? What's going on? He's having an in-character discussion, so I must be
present.
Alright. I'm starting to feel a lot of pain.
I'm starting to feel like tonight might have been a waste. But unfortunately, if I didn't come, I would have been out. I'm really glad Bobby didn't make it. Like, I don't mean it in a mean way, it's just... This is the only thing that gets me out of my house besides school. And if I had missed, it'd have been me. Even if Bobby had missed, it'd have been me. Because I was first on the list to, I was number one on the list to, if I didn't make it, I'm out.
Are you the same level as everybody?
Is everyone level six?
I'm almost seven, so.
Yeah. I'm only 2,000 experience behind everyone.
I was actually introduced to the party as a lower level than I could have been. Because
of your level adjustment.
He forced the level adjustment on me. There was no level adjustment.
Well, yeah, but you're also, like, the way the anthropomorphic ape is set up, you really are
OP. I spent two levels on it, and it's two hit dice. and he made me spend 3 levels for 2 hit dice. Yeah, it's technically I shouldn't have been able to do it, but it's still
got a white light.
There was a 3.0 book for it, but not 3.5. So if you just want to use
we should probably still leave it plugged in.
If I'm charging still.
Actually, you have the books on your computer, right?
It's not really charging.
Could you check and see if you have some of the Citadel?
It says charging, but it's not some charging.
Citadel? Yes.
If that makes any sense. I guess because it's USB, it's really slow.
Yeah, no.
Alright.
Need that book.
I have Sandstorm, Serpent Kingdoms, Raining South, Silver Marches, Suns of.
Yeah, I have most of those.
Boom. Golden Kingdom, Storm Rack. That's all my S's.
See, I saw Storm Rack, and that's got some good modules in it. But I'm doing a small DM campaign at my house with my sisters, and I'm just working on that because I want to practice being a DM myself. And I can't find any EL2 modules. They're only second level. I didn't give them any NPCs. Well, I know what their party is. A rogue that never wants to play, so never cares, and a druid who doesn't seem to understand that her wolf is not invincible.
What?
No, yeah. I'm DMing at home with my sisters, right? And my sister made a druid, and my other sister made a rogue. The rogue doesn't care, and the druid doesn't seem to understand that her wolf is not invincible. She's fighting 5 giant ants, and what she does is, all right, 5 foot step backwards, and my wolf runs up and just fights all 5 ants. All 5 ants are by themselves. The rogue's not even over there. The rogue didn't do anything. The druid just sat there and let her wolf die. Like, literally, they had just made their characters. I was like, all right, what are y'all doing? My puppy's going to go attack. I was like, it's not a puppy. She's like, yes, it is. I'm like, all right, so it's going to do half damage. Just because I, yeah. And, all
right. That's called cheating.
Clarissa, what are you doing? And actually, no.
legitimately the ingrained knowledge.
Yes. When it reduced animal reduces the damage by half. So if it's a puppy, it's half the size of an adult wolf. It'd be half damage. And I was like, also have one less hit die. That really sucks for her. She went from 18 health to 9 on her wolf.
Nice.
It died.
Nice.
I even gave it the rule of, you know what? I'll be nice because it's your animal companion. I'll allow it to go to negative constitution instead of 0 dead. It died.
The rogue didn't go help it?
See, no, the rogue was this, all right? Clarissa didn't care. I was about to say, I'm about to NPC your character. She's like, no, don't do that. I was like, are you going to do something? Yes. 6 5-foot step. I was like, you know what? Fuck it. At least Addison's starting to get better at it now. Like, I did another encounter later on that was just one eagle. Not even a giant eagle, just a regular old eagle. She almost died, but that was because it was, oh, your wolf isn't looking too well, and it's only got 9 hit points. And she's like, oh my god, let me go run away and heal it. Alright, cast Cure Light Wounds. She's like, no, I need to run away. Okay. I need to get her to understand. Scared to be willing to do a D&D campaign with me as DM?
This piece of modern art is my answer.
That doesn't tell me anything. Actually, it popped up, and that's kind of like a nod. Is that a yes?
Yeah, I crossed well for him today. Because I ran out. I actually ran out of javelins, but I might go get some more javelins. Because at least with javelins, I have all my strength, and I'm very strong.
Offer an answer. Okay. Want some help with those eyes, buddy?
I think it's good to have a range weapon.
I heard human eyes are a good delicacy somewhere, so if I got there, it wouldn't be illegal.
No, well, you want to know where they're a delicacy?
Russia.
Ancient.
Hmm. Let me figure out where it's legal, though. It's not legal here to do that. Not if the person's still alive. Wait.
Alright.
Hold on. Is it illegal here in America to spoon out someone's eyeballs and eat them?
Only if they're alive. Wait. It depends. I believe in Texas and Alaska they signed a consent form.
Cannibalism is not illegal.
No, but it is if the person's still alive.
Yeah, it's kind of illegal in the act of killing it to actually eat it.
Now, if you kill it, that is illegal. But eating if the body's if the body dies of natural causes, okay, like old age or
you can eat it. Or like if you're on a mountaintop and you're about to die, and the other guy dies before you do, you actually eat it to try to stay alive.
If you get his permission.
No, actually,
you have to get permission.
Actually, hold Mitchell, in that case, if the guys are dead, then you eat
them. He's dead. I can get permission.
It's
wake up! Give me permission to eat
you.
No, you
have to get permission before they die.
No. The consent thing is
okay, then you can just tell the cops. You can tell the cops
you
gave you permission. How would they know?
You're in a hole.
Can they prove it? Well, prove it that the dead person told you he gave permission. You have a written document that's signed by him that said you can eat him after he dies.
Yeah.
No?
Well, no,
you're going to prison.
But that's only if they're still alive and you're eating them that you need consent.
All
right, just take his finger and while he's still dead and
put
pen in his hand,
then you don't need consent.
Sign.
By the way, DM, I'm with my grandparents tonight, so I gotta leave at 11.
You have to leave at 11.
So are we to town yet?
Are your parents coming to get you, grandparents?
They are.
So I can meet them tonight.
Sure.
Okay. Alright. I'll wander out.
Can you do what the requirements is for enhancement bonus? Like to make it?
Can we see if we leveled up?
We did.
Huh?
We did.
I only had like 100 and something, 180 something.
It just costs the money.
We had the experience, we just didn't kill anything.
So there's no requirements to make it.
We really have no experience, just got.
Requirement?
Yeah.
Otherwise, when we get to the village. I guess we'll have to just pull up for a while he helps me.
Hold on. Throw some use foreign on your neck.
Good, feel good.
That's a fantastic.
Ooh.
Yeah, I don't think there is any. What's your migraine medicine?
Something.
No stupid pills.
It's a stupid pill.
Is it Imitrax?
I'm
a track.
I gotta just start going along with the rocking.
So, second generation.
David, mama,
the only prerequisite for beast skin though is ironwood and craft magic
trigger.
Armor.
I do. You kept a headache diary to try to figure it out. You should log all the things that you eat. Whether you get adequate sleep the night before, et cetera, because all of these things are possible triggers, and then you can narrow it down and try to stop these things before they happen.
Yes. You can tell you what I had today. Would it be today or yesterday?
So you've been recording for 47 hours.
Or
47 minutes. Yeah, I know.
I don't know. We haven't been here for
47 Bendover.
Hold on. You can't say Bendover. Sorry.
Well,
he just did.
I will admit, I do this nerve and denial.
That's not how you do it. DM question.
It's like, alright.
Yeah, no, you tapped it down. No, Denozo's like this. It's just like the top of the head.
Okay.
Yeah, that's.
Low blood sugar?
I mean, it still sucks to hit me, but I mean, it's better that you got the Denozo right.
Now, what ends up happening is your sugar comes up when you eat these things, and then your sugar will die.
I don't want to
have hyperglycemia, and that can trigger a migraine.
Greg looks like he's falling asleep.
So, that's a possibility. Looks right,
high.
Question.
That's one sip.
What's the question?
No, high, not drunk.
What's the question?
High.
Same difference. Even though we didn't kill anything, did we get XP for the experience?
You survived the encounter. You get XP.
Barely.
Okay. So, can we level up now?
No, we have an hour left. You'll be getting XP. You will certainly be leveling tonight.
There's
you
a small lag on your computer.
There's a who?
Okay. David, I do not see any requirements for
might
crafting
be.
In the
like, it doesn't go with the motion.
All they need to
slightly
have is
behind.
To do it. Yeah.
You see it, Mitchell?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So, the afternoon, okay, good. All right.
I like how he doesn't care that we're mentioning it.
According to this, there was only 148 apes in the entire U.S.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. That would certainly be a little bit off if we weren't counting humans.
Huh?
I
think it's in the animal, yeah.
Oh, 4,005 wild.
People?
Yes, people.
4,000 wild apes. In the U.S.?
Maybe.
Is someone let him out one day?
Mm-hmm. Thank
you. Yeah, the puppy.
This is a booby.
I don't want protophobia.
Yes.
Alright.
I have my ape rising. Okay, there's 4 more points.
It's extremely
easy to begin. But then after that, it does get really difficult.
Like, the humans killing all the apes, and if all the apes
die, then
you lose. So,
it's
next morning, you got
your spells. You do have your new
spells. And we're walking.
And you are walking. You are getting within a couple of hours of the village. The village that the tiefling is convinced contains a king and his court.
Fortunately, the knight's nice is good.
Yeah, they lied.
Wait, what knights?
They didn't trust you with the knowledge of where their home base actually
is. It's like they, from their, like someone saying, oh yeah, I'm gonna be out of town, but my big black boyfriend, he's 7 foot tall, he has a huge Great Dane, he's gonna be watching the house for me.
My boyfriend. My black boyfriend.
Right.
My digger.
WHO raises threat level for Harambe due to extremely rapid evolution, caused by DNA instability.
Harambe,
you know you're unstable. Really
that would kill all of you.
Yes. That's what you should do.
If you want to give us something really nasty that would kill all of us, grab that big old demon right there.
Okay.
You say, you should be able to
Mitchell,
shut
up.
Grab him in the balls.
I was just joking. Do not grab that.
We will totally grab Mitchell in the balls.
None of these strike me as interesting right now. So, you guys managed to drag yourselves into the village. It is pretty small. It is there's a palisade around it, which probably makes you think that it's greater than it is, but it's not, because the palisade was only crafted because this is a frontier area and it was dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
So the the log palisade is there to keep the enemies from entering.
Where's this big city? Here? He brought us to.
Here.
The largest
I'm sorry, I can't help with the knights lying to me. Nothing I can do about that. Speaking of which, while we're here, though, I want to ask them about this big city they were talking about.
That's a good one. So we don't have anywhere where we can actually barter or anything.
I have a blacksmith. He's got a weaponsmith.
So we just wasted 3 days.
Can we look for somebody?
Gone into a town.
That has nothing in it.
That has nothing for
us. There is a hedge wizard in town that will identify items for you for 150 gold per item.
But that's only 50 more gold than what it would cost us.
That we have a way of detecting our own work.
Okay.
It's amazing that you're not getting.
Who's not getting what?
Derek.
Okay.
If only we had someone here to help us with that.
Yeah, but the wizard doesn't care enough about this.
Have you tried asking him?
level.
Actually,
of,
yeah, he would, but we have to, like, buy $100 or 100 gold rolls each time. So it's always be saving
two.
Yes.
By the way, I don't have it memorized. I don't have the spell identifier memorized.
And remember, it takes a 100 gold piece pearl every time you cast it. But it would have allowed you to memorize, to identify six items.
So one casting allows me to identify six
if
items?
If he can do that instead, I'd prefer to pay one.
Okay. Well, he doesn't have it memorized, but he can memorize it tomorrow if you'd like. You're going to have to get a 100 gold piece pearl here in town. Let me make sure that it is like I remember. And identify does allow you to do one per level.
Spicy good.
All right. Identify one. Nope, it's only one object.
Great.
How lame is that?
So I'll just go ahead and spend the 150.
Okay. You're going to spend the 150 instead of him doing it for 100. Mm-hmm. All right.
Well, actually,
said there's a blacksmith. Would he make armor?
I said there's a blacksmith, not a weaponsmith. An armorsmith. So if you would like to have an armor
made
that is made out of horseshoes, he could probably accommodate you.
He can't make a dagger.
What?
Oh, he could make a dagger. It'll suck. And you'll probably want to wear it on your shoe.
Well,
can you make Harambe?
Can you make a switchblade shoe?
Yeah, he specializes in animals.
That would be awesome.
So
your shoe, you hit your heel and the blade pops out.
Do you think that there's a lot of call for ape shoes in this village?
Could he make
anthropomorphic apes. Exactly.
Could he make a shoe that you tap your heel and a blade
apes
flies out?
For Harambe in Norway. People in Norway are becoming increasingly worried about Harambe.
Because there's not a lot of horses
that have blades.
Where they stamp their foot and out comes a blade. Pretty confident.
But we can buy horseshoes from them to use as throwing weapons.
Yeah, you can link it around their neck.
Happy to sell you as many horseshoes as you would like to buy.
I want five. I want five horseshoes.
Okay, these daggers, though.
How much damage do you think you're going to do with a fucking horse?
I have no idea. I might find a horse, actually, and have an extra shoe just in case.
Or he might find a five-legged horse. You never know.
What? Okay.
So the silver
pray
dagger.
Tell.
Short,
is
short
that masterwork?
Going out and catching your own horse.
The silver dagger, is it masterwork?
Training him and breaking him to be rideable. I'm pretty sure the horse you get is going to have shoes on.
Remember where this was. Where was it from?
Well, pray tell, what else do we get to do here besides buy horseshoes?
You're in three different modules.
You gave it to us.
Alright.
So I spent one piece of gold
to
buy five horseshoes.
Probably that tomb. Okay. Oh, there it is. Not
masterwork. I don't give a breastplate.
No. The breastplate was masterwork. The
I know those
leather things. Was masterwork. Green. The long sword was masterwork. Light crossbow was masterwork.
Why do you have holy water?
That was it.
I blew
oh,
on
no,
it.
The great axe was masterwork.
To
and
fight
the
off
mighty
people.
Composite longbow was not
masterwork.
Now, what would happen if you were to fall
right
and okay. It just happened?
Is somebody actually using
he doesn't know that.
No.
He doesn't know that you have holy water?
No. I'm going to tell him.
I'm not proficient.
What would happen if
no,
you
but there's
fall?
A
if I had it, I told him I'm going
to
use it, then I fall over.
That's different.
You also have firewood for some reason?
I'm going to let you think about that.
It's not
I had all this stuff
not
before.
It's not
him.
You made sure I knew that.
Yeah, it is not him.
So if he's not proficient. So if he is proficient.
He is proficient. He's not strong enough.
He is not proficient.
Okay.
What are we talking
he
about?
He is not proficient.
Correct.
You think he's proficient?
Uh-huh.
Proficient in what?
He's been using javelins all this time.
Yeah.
Instead of the bow, which is a far superior weapon.
Yeah.
And master, sort of mighty composite.
Do we have shops that I can buy javelins? I need to stock up.
Yeah, I think that they could certainly provide you. Because some people hunt with javelins. Not very good people. I mean, they tend to hit trees a lot. And,
so, is there any way I can get a masterwork dagger here?
I'm going to buy six.
Okay. I'm going to say yes. That the horseshoe repair individual could spend... Hold on, to craft a masterwork dagger. I'm trying to stick his finger up here. Okay, hold on. Crafting a masterwork item. Masterwork.
Well, you have to learn that, or you already knows how to do it?
You better go back right now.
What did he want?
You have 5 seconds.
Five.
Is this from yours?
I didn't see. Wait, is that on yours, Craig? Okay.
That's mine.
Oh, yeah, go ahead. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
Okay,
yeah, just
so
down
for
it for your pleasure, straight
to
up.
Make a
go back and sit down.
Dagger for you.
If you make that fall.
Okay. Okay. He does have artisan's tools, so we're good with that. A dagger is. Okay.
It's so long to double tap that. That's not.
The cost of a masterwork dagger.
Here, hold on. Let me check. Where's the power button?
302 gold.
Deal.
Okay, now hold on. That determines how long it takes him to make it.
I can get skill will to give him +10 or whatever.
Okay. Well, he's certainly willing to take advantage of your spell. Alright, so on the item price 302. Okay, so in silver pieces, 3,200. Find the DC. Okay, so the DC is Masterwork, Martial, no, Simple Melee, Weaponsmith. The DC is 12. Okay.
Oh, so he's going to pass. Hmm.
Yes, but depending upon how high he rolls, make an appropriate craft check representing 1 week's work. Okay, if
it's 2 weeks,
multiply your check result by the DC. Okay, so you're going to cast the spell. All week, every morning, right? You're going to go ahead and kind of...
Why not?
Now, you guys know that his plan is to wait around for at least a week
to
have this guy craft him a masterwork dagger.
He's waiting by himself.
Okay.
If you guys want to leave the rogue, that's fine.
I'm willing to wait. You're willing to wait with him for as long as it takes for the creation of this. Because we only know...
A masterwork.
I honestly don't care. So far, I followed him and it's...
A masterwork dagger?
Two.
Actually, that's going to do what?
So no, the point is...
It's going to do two...
The point is, I can't have them enchanted by him unless they're magical, or unless they're masterwork. Now, I'd like to be able to sneak attack undead. I found a way to do so. I need to enchant these first. Otherwise, I'll just have to be useless and run away every time I fight undead in a dungeon full of undead.
So you're making two masterwork daggers and having me enchant them.
Okay, I want my daggers to be masterwork, too.
Okay. So,
will it take 2 weeks?
Don't you want to use a great axe?
Yeah, I use a great
axe. I honestly
don't have a magic great axe.
But if
it's a level,
really
level 1 commoner, so the most he can have for his craft would be 4 ranks in craft blacksmithing, maybe count him as having 11 intelligence. I mean, that's pushing it for a commoner, so that gives him a +1. So he's got a 5. Okay. Are you, every morning, are you casting this spell?
Yes.
To give him a +10 on his check?
Yes.
Okay.
And are we getting random encounters for a whole week?
I hate for us to fail.
No, we're
inside
of the town.
Inside a village. What's that?
I said we're inside a village, so we shouldn't really be getting any.
Unless you're hoping for random encounters of commoners coming up and mugging you that
random
you're not allowed in the town because
I submit.
So yeah,
bring it.
Come up with some other solution.
You should join the village guard and guard the town until we leave.
Guard the town with your smell.
But if you
were
to say that we are here, I'm going to pray for my 24 hours. I'm about to get animal companion.
Can I get the rope just for me?
I'm going to borrow my
I climb up every day?
Well, it's only good for 12 hours.
Every day?
It's only good for 12 hours.
So the other 12 hours, I'm farting around.
Or you can convince him to maybe cast it twice.
Yeah.
Well, you know, David.
Can you cast it twice in a day?
Okay, so while they're doing their stuff, I'm going around.
Oh, my God.
If there's a closer city that takes 2 days to walk, they can do a masterwork dagger in a day. That saves us 11 days.
Is there?
He's finding out.
Look at a cheetah.
We're going to get a
cheetah.
Most of the
I'm looking at a cheetah.
They were doing this.
In this area,
be a pain in my butt.
Right.
I told him, fine.
Towards
you want to be like that? Well, wait.
Years ago. And so the monsters have done a decent job in retaking most of this area. They've lost contact with everything further in. The knights that patrol the roads are based in this village.
Unit vector must fit.
What?
Be smelling. I'm smelly.
They don't speak of a larger city. There are rumors that there are cities that are further inland.
Holy fuck.
That may have survived sending armies after Rappahannock, only to have them all.
Once per hour, it can move 10 times its normal speed, up to 500 feet.
How far are these cities?
So let me figure out how long it's going to take to make each of these daggers. Okay.
Will it take longer to do that than to go to a big city and have them make it in a day?
No, you can't make it in a day unless you're talking about a super duper master that, you know, like a 20th level blacksmith could possibly do this. But
wait, didn't I get my masterwork axe made in a day?
No, we're not going to have one.
Oh.
Fortunately, we also
so if we go to a big city, wouldn't they have them lying around?
An alcoholic getting
I took a stupid pill and my
this was a settled area. And when the evil priests moved in to Rappahannock and settled there, the good towns sent an army against
them.
All that army died to a man. And since that time, 100 years ago, the
Greg doesn't appreciate your impersonation of it.
So this village is out of touch with anybody who might have survived deeper inland.
And
maybe larger cities there still, or they may have all been destroyed.
So this is the only one that we know of, so we just need to bank up. We need to bank on the one where we're at.
So, where'd you come from? Let's see. So, okay, so again, most we're looking at is a 15 with your spell and his natural stats. Okay, so the 15 multiplier check result by the DC.
Okay, well, since we're sitting here for 2 weeks, can I go ahead and level up?
Okay, so his check is a 31. So 31 times 12.
You're
going to
be productive.
By the way, for the first day of parade, and
you're hoping that I'm going to do mental math. I'm going to listen to you telling me what you're doing. I don't have a drink.
I got
you. I'm really bad right now. Give me a moment to calculate the one thing I'm working on.
Give
the
me a moment to
look
perfect.
I'll deal with everybody else.
Silent, but deadly.
372. All right. So, 372. Okay. If the DC, if it equals the price of the item in silver pieces, then you've completed the item. You have not. So at this rate, it's going to take about 9 days, I think. Let's see. 3,
for one dagger?
Yes, 3,002 divided by 372 equals, oh, only 8 days, sorry. So 8 days, so 16 days at this rate will get you your two daggers.
Okay.
Well, after to fix the first one, then you become more proficient and you can do it in half the time. All right, so 16 days have gone by.
Do that because technically, it would have to work all day long.
Well, I'm not entirely sure how long it lasts. I think
the next check
by default it would be.
It's the next check ends up. It was supposed to happen the next round, basically.
All right, it's 10:30, and somebody has to leave at 11.
So would you instead like for me to give you XP, and then you, those of you who can level, can work on making your level, or what? What do you want to do?
I mean, how long is it going to take for 8 days? So we can say 8 days has passed. 16. Can you just say it's passed?
And keep going? Oh,
there
ain't a wizard
to
enchant
it. Okay, so you can commit suicide within 1 day, and then that will save you the other 15 days.
Did not stop.
Okay.
I'm going to look for a Harambe.
You're looking for a Harambe?
Yeah.
Okay. What are you doing?
I'm praying for the first day for my cheetah.
Also, have you thought about wild shaping into a female ape? And then seducing him a la Bugs Bunny.
Or he can make a companion.
Also,
or he can make an ape companion. No, a female ape companion for him.
You big boy.
I would try to convert.
Okay.
Me too.
So you're looking to get your freak on. And
after that, he's going to go, I've seen God.
Okay, you're committing suicide. What are you doing, Richard?
I mean, I'm going to go out, like, see if I can find a monster. Everybody
else is okay, so you're going to go out and try to solo.
I'll go with him.
You have to go with him because you're not in the town. You're not allowed to be in the town.
I thought I was roping up and roping down first.
Yes, you're roping the rope, down.
I'm just going to follow that guy around.
Okay, so...
Can't we just go for wilderness encounters for kicks while we wait for these stupid daggers to be in
there? So for 16 days, the wizard is just like standing there right next to you the whole time.
Well,
just staring at you.
At night, I'll be resting. Hey, man, at night, I'm resting. Okay.
Great. So 16 days are over.
Y'all can go play Walmart while me and Lewis have a go.
Okay, so you know what we could do?
We could just go to the pub and have be pissing people off with my stink.
You can't be in the town. You can't be in the town.
I have an axe that says otherwise.
Yes. You would like to hack your way into town.
Wait until after the daggers are made. And we sell stuff.
I don't know you're making daggers. What the hell you're doing?
Yeah, because you're out of town.
Out of town, out of mind. Why do you? Hey guys, you want to go bury that guy this morning?
Well, you can roll this. You can roll to see if he randomly bumps into me out of town. He can smell.
They'll give you half.
Damn, he can smell me a mile away. He can follow the smell and go, hey, you want to go hunting?
You're up in the rope trip at the time. You're only out long enough for Mitchell to
come back out.
He needs to come out and recast it and then go back into the town to find his friend.
But he's hanging with him, he might forget, and I'm stuck there in the middle of the war, man.
You might, yeah.
Wait, what do I need to cast?
He wants you to cast Rope Trick twice a day.
No.
Extended. And he will just climb up there and live in there for 16 days while you gaze lovingly upon the
people. I'm not gazing lovingly, okay?
I just don't know. It kind of seems like it.
I just don't know what else to do, so I'm following him.
Well, you're following him, all right.
I hate to see you go, but I like to watch you leave.
No, I'll be looking for a Harambe.
I can't cast two
after
spells
after I have my
today.
Cheetah, I'll
can
go with
him. Can you cast two level 2 spells a day?
Yeah. Oh, no.
You're 6.
You certainly get... More than 2.
You're not going to be doing anything else, but messing with him. What else are you going to do?
Fine, I'll do it for you.
You're going to practice your magic missiles?
You actually can cast 4 second level spells a day.
How much is a wand of mage armor worth?
Okay. Well, then I'll.
750?
You can sleep with me.
Hey, do you want the wand of mage armor?
I have mage armor spell, but sure.
Yes.
Keep in mind that it only lasts for 1 hour.
Mage armor or
wand? The wand.
How long does the mage armor last? 6 hours?
6 hours. If you cast it, not on the wand, it lasts for 1 hour per level. The wand is a first level caster.
What the hell? Let's just spend the whole month here. I want 2 days.
Except for the fact that this doesn't take up a spell slot. Correct. And you can just cast it again. And again. And again.
Every time you cast it, it costs money.
No, it does not cost money. It costs a charge off the wand.
Right, which is permanently gone.
You can't be good. No, let's just sell.
Okay, that'll be 7.
Like I said, after
some
I might...
That's like getting a free...
Like I said,
some of them
spell.
Have charges per day, some of them have charges that permanently...
Okay, the tree tokens. Is that doing anything special?
Are you going after the first day, or are you going to have a day of rest?
Oh, yeah,
one's
out from Magic Rod. Yeah, I was
looking
that up
before. I'll go with you,
because I'm not sitting
here. Show my character on my camera. Okay, get my hex blade in my. I want to show it on camera.
Okay.
In my dark companion.
That's fine.
David, can you get my figures?
Oh,
I want to put it on camera. He's farting around with his balls over there.
So we can finally be rid of all this treasure.
Oh, the wand of mage armor only had 5 charges on it.
Okay.
So 750. 50 divided by 5.
That one only has 5 charges on it.
What's that?
That one only has 5 charges on it. Does it have a little bar on it? Cell phone bars showing how much damage charges it has left?
A wizard. Anybody who has the spell on their spell list.
Yeah.
All right, where the hell is it? I believe, without looking it up, that it's a rod of metal detection. Let's see.
So a metal detector.
And this is my companion.
So,
anyway.
Yes.
Of the three people out here for when this treasure was earned.
Which was made you next.
Metal and mineral detection.
That will be 2,250 gold each.
Okay. Nice. It is worth 10,500 gold. This rod pulses
so
the ruler's hand and points to the largest mass of metal within 30 feet.
No, it's up.
Yes. However, the wheel is concentrated on specific metal or mineral. Gold, platinum, quartz, beryl, diamond, conundrum, and so on. If the specific mineral is within 30 feet, the rod points any place that's located, and the rod wielder knows the approximate quantity as well. If more than one deposit of the specified mineral is within range, the rod points the largest cache first. Each operation requires a full round action.
Wait, so what is the rod for? So what does it do? I'm sorry.
Don't worry about
it. It's basically a metal detector.
Oh, it's a metal detector. That's all it does?
Basically. Metal and mineral
so,
detector.
So, we can get
full
price? We'll wait.
It's in pristine condition. I'll even polish it.
Factory new.
Polish the rod.
It's stat track.
No, while he's going up and down the rope, you're polishing your rod.
And Kane is giving one mighty blow!
I'm doing a lot of things.
Kane is Bugs Bunnying you.
I never said that.
No.
No. Like, I walked out.
As
I couldn't even
do it. Found out that the ape is looking for love and all.
How about this? How about I use some of Nature's Allies to summon a female ape for him?
Mitchell, you.
You monster.
Use my knife without my permission.
Thanks a lot.
I'm so triggered! I need my safe space!
Trigger.
I can use your flight.
You were straight for it, too.
Yep, I knew what you were doing, so.
You know, Harambe was a little voice blanky.
And he got shot.
Okay, so you're going to summon Nature's Ally to summon a celestial female ape.
It's not celestial, I ain't high enough.
Oh, my Nature's Ally isn't. Summon monster is celestial or
fiendish. Yeah. Only when you're someone who can do that.
Okay, so you're going to summon one for all of 6 rounds.
Yep.
If
yep,
you
just
can
right.
finish in 6 rounds.
36 seconds.
36 seconds.
Do you have extend spell?
Well, it's, I would say I'm impressed, but I'm not impressed.
As an ape.
I'm
as an ape. I would not have sex for pleasure. It would be solely for reproduction.
There you go.
You do realize that's the case for everything but apes, right?
I know apes like prostitutes.
You know,
here's
things
the thing,
that...
he doesn't actually know that it can last for so long.
Apes are the only things that can actually enjoy blowjobs.
If you were a dog and you were not enough inside it, I wonder if you'd go with it.
Dolphins and humans are the only species on Earth that have sex for pleasure.
Bonobos do too, and various
I disagree with you.
Types of apes will do that.
Mm-hmm. Well, okay, fine. Dolphins, apes, and humans.
Well, I said I'd go with him after I had my tear. And he said he's staying for one day.
You
so I'm
I, which I do.
If you want help, I climb down just for a breather. And he smells
so
me and comes and picks me up.
People who don't breathe don't need breathing.
Well, wait.
I'm not totally indulged yet. I still think I'm brave.
Boy, so.
Which one of us?
All right, so let's see. Something that is just the two of you.
Just the two of us. Okay. We can
I
make it if we try.
Oh, I thought you were about to start singing Eminem.
I haven't heard that.
It's not just the two of us.
The only one I've heard is. Stop. I said maybe stop collaborating.
But no, Eminem's got one.
Here
he is.
Back,
he's singing
back
the,
again.
He's
back. Back
okay,
to my friend.
There's one that Eminem does. It's the second part of a song.
Okay, so
he's singing it to his daughter after he killed his wife.
Don't worry, baby. I just killed your mama. It'll be all right. Just don't tell the cops on me. She had an accident, fell on a knife 25 times.
At first she was Cody, but then she just started slipping around.
She was a... like, hurt yourself.
No.
It's a term for it. What's the term for it? You like to cut yourself and stuff?
Emo.
Alright.
Masochist.
So,
masochist. Yeah, she's a masochist. So she just kept slicing the dice until there was nothing left.
Now, technically, a masochist is someone who enjoys pain. Someone who
I like my flesh to spike with pain in.
Right. Somebody who just cuts themselves over and over again is a cut.
My aeroplane.
Okay. All right, so you guys are, the two of you are crashing through the woods together, hand in hand.
Well, I don't know about crashing. I think it's a little more methodical.
Hey,
I know you think you're going to do it without me, but y'all might need a hex.
Okay, crashing, yes. Well, I'm clanking, so that's fine. All right, you're right.
One second.
A person who
but
has
they should know that I they should know that I'm up here.
A person
with they just don't think they need me. Y'all can do this by yourself.
He decided he would wander off, and whoever followed him would be fine. You are up inside.
Fine. Have at it. I'm here. I'm up,
I'm
up in another plane, jerking off while y'all gonna have fun.
So I guess I'll go with
you. It sounds like there's no.
My appendage fell off.
Yes, you have one.
And you gotta cast that thing for the.
Yeah, I only do that like once a day, though.
Well, hon, Jerry, remember you're busy with the Harambe by summoning.
Yeah, I'm gonna find a Harambe in the city.
I summoned one for you, remember?
No.
Yes, yes. I said summon nature ally, and I summoned you a Harambe. I just, yeah. I hope you finished in 30 seconds, 36
and
seconds.
I didn't want none of that.
Oh, no, I didn't tell you about that, and you wouldn't actually know about it. So, you would just go with it.
No.
Yeah. You wouldn't know that ends in six rounds. You don't have that spell.
You're assuming that I'm going to do something.
You're trying
to roleplay my character for me.
No, I'm assuming that you don't know anything about the spell, I guess.
Are you assuming
his gender?
My sexual preference?
No.
I'm triggered. He's triggering.
No,
he's triggering
I doubt you'll find any apes.
He's assuming my sexual.
I doubt you'll find any apes out in these woods.
Well, since I'm by myself, I don't
how
need to do
like
any myself diary at this point, because I don't know what the hell's going on.
No, not a key.